once there was a land called Davan, a land far to the west, across the Taklamakan Desert and over the Tian Shan Mountains. It was a great, rich valley, and 2,000 years ago, its name was known even in Chang'an, in distant China. Silk Road camera team now sets off for the Fergana Basin of the Uzbek Soviet Socialist Republic, where we too hope to find Davan. We are some 100 kilometers across the border from China into the Soviet Union, on a mountain road along the western edge of the Tian Shan Range. Here winds the convoluted border between the Kyrgyz and the Uzbek Soviet Socialist Republics. The road is frequently blocked by herds of sheep. The Chaban, or shepherds of Kyrgyz, drive their herds to the mountain pastures at dawn, then return home at sunset. We meet a boy of entirely oriental features. Fergana Basin, enclosed to the north by the Tian Shan Mountains, to the south by the Pamirs, 300 kilometers long and 150 kilometers wide. Ancient chronicle, Davan was 2,500 kilometers west of China. The people of this land grew rice and wheat and make wine. Davan had over 70 cities and a population of hundreds of thousands. Their weapons were bows and spears, and they were skilled in combat on horses. Every Sunday, the towns of Fergana come to life with the weekly bazaar. Shoppers take a break in the shade of trees, eating snacks and drinking tea and other beverages. This is the Kuvasai Bazaar. Thank you. One popular item is strawberries gathered from the fields the same morning. They may be irregular in shape, but their flavour is exquisite. The smoke of this herb, when inhaled, supposedly cures all types of disease.
How to use?
No. Dishes, not
body.
No,
body.
Dishes.
Only the and body.
Salmon.
Body, same in Japan.
This is the great Sidaria River, which rises in the Tian Shan Mountains and flows westward through the Fergana Basin. Here, along the river, tower earthen walls 30 meters high. Once, these walls protected the capital of Fergana, Aksikent. The history of Aksikent begins 5 centuries before the time of Christ. At its peak, over 400,000 people lived here. Set in the midst of the lush Fergana Valley, the city prospered and became a major stop on the Silk Road. But when the 13th century brought the invading army of Genghis Khan, Aksikent was destroyed. Local archaeologists began excavations here 4 years ago. So far, they say, a mere 3% of the city has been uncovered. And thus the ancient land of Davan, first known to the Eastern world 2 centuries before Christ, still remains largely hidden in the sand. In the year 139 before Christ, a man set off west from Han China. His name was Shazam. Under orders from Emperor Udi, Shazam spent 13 years exploring the lands of the west. Udi was highly interested in the report Shazam brought back. He was particularly fascinated by the tales of the sky horses of Davan. It was said these creatures could gallop 250 kilometers in a day and sweated from their bodies a red liquid like blood. Davan, where the sky horses lived, was said to be 2,500 kilometers away, but Udi could not keep the thought of them from his mind. At last he sent off a huge army to bring him the sky horses. History books write that it comprised 60,000 soldiers, 30,000 cavalry horses, and tens of thousands of mules and camels. Across the desert and over the Tian Shan mountains, they struggled. Finally, after 4 years of hardship, General Li Guanli returned triumphantly with over 3,000 sky horses. This 35 centimeter tall statue of a galloping horse was found in a Han period cave. There can be no doubt that this indeed is one of the flying horses that so captivated the Emperor Udi. The path taken by the Han army to Davan subsequently grew into an active trade route. It was the sky horses, in other words, that touched off exchange between China and Davan. The people of Fergana tell us that the legend of the sky horses still lives on. And so we go to the steppes, to the east of Fergana, to hear the tales at their source. We cross a rocky line of mountains and enter the Kyrgyz Soviet Socialist Republic. Here the steppe extends as far as the eye can see. This is the domain of the Kyrgyz, the descendants of a race of intrepid horsemen. It could well be that here, on this plain, 2,000 years ago, grazed and galloped the sky horses. When we asked the old horseman about the sky horses, he said that they are connected with the legend of the horses of Manas. They came from a canyon. He explained that these horses could run fast, but also much more. They could drink dry a whole river, or even all of the Lake Issyk-Kul. And then, without eating or drinking, they could run for months over fields or mountains. The old man concluded that he didn't know anything about sweating blood, but he did know that they have disappeared from Fergana.
Ошонан кийин анан суу ичкен да. Yemin su içkende olsun, bir dairen su olsun, biri içip şimirip atkanı aktır bayatkanı.
こちらのおじいさんもね、両方黒いマント着てるんですよね、こういう風な。Their
black capes were typical of the local dress.
こちらの衣装ですね。あ、やっぱりこれもコートみたいになってますね。ああ、だ。ああ、で、乗馬しやすいようにやっぱり、あの足はズボンで。And
their breeches made specially for riding were of corduroy. And so we see how the people of Kyrgyz still live with their horses. The horseman that we interviewed was 71 years old, yet he moved with the ease of a much younger man. Emperor Udi was not the only one captivated by these sky horses. The Chinese of following generations continued to sing their praises. The Chinese poet Du Pu wrote, "The famed horse of Davan, slender-boned and hard-muscled, eyes as sharp as the bamboo, legs as swift as the wind. However dangerous the path, entrust them with your life, for these are valiant horses, and they run 10,000 li." In the small Fergana town of Margilan, Friday prayers are about to begin. The caps the men wear are called chubtika. They are exactly like the caps we saw in the Xinjiang Uyghur Autonomous Region of China. The Fergana Basin is still largely Muslim. As Muslims everywhere, the worshippers cleanse themselves before praying. From his minaret, the muezzin calls out to worshippers. The mosque in Margilan was built over 400 years ago and is the oldest in the Fergana Basin. In the courtyard with its trellises of grapevines assemble over 2,000 worshippers. All of the worshippers here are men, and almost all are elderly. There is barely a young face to be seen. Some of the faces look almost oriental, others western. But in the face of every one of these aged worshippers is etched the long history of Middle Asia.
Hayya 'ala s-salah.
although the Soviet government guaranteed freedom of worship from the 1917 revolution, it originally promoted the view that no God exists. For Muslims and other religious minorities in the Soviet Union, it was a time of confusion and difficulty. Some believers took up arms and fought the government policy. The uprisings were particularly fierce here in Middle Asia. Today, these elderly Muslims pray quietly to their own God, with peace in their hearts. There are many mulberry bushes throughout the Fergana Basin, for here, along with cotton and vegetables, a major product is silk. We understand the chief of this collective farm has someone he's very proud of. The farm families of this region have one thing in common, lots of children. In fact, mothers who have 10 or more children receive an official commendation. This is the mother the farm is so proud of. The husband's name is Tozumito. And his wife, Marinisa. She was wearing her awards and explained that they were presented to her for raising children. The first one after four, then five, six, seven, eight, nine, and the mother hero after 10. We are joined by the whole family. The oldest of their children was a daughter, 35 years old. And the youngest, a son, just 12 years old. Tojimoto told us there is an old Fergana saying, the more children there are, the happier they will be.
幸せになるという。
mehnat qilamiz devlat yordam beradi
deb
In all, 11 children and 18 grandchildren so far. Mothers who have 10 or more children are also given special benefits. They are allowed free passage on domestic trains and airplanes, and they have priority in buying houses and cars. The Tojimoto family raises silkworms, and here we see the women trimming branches from the mulberry trees. Taking care of the silkworms is the women's work. It is now May, the busy season for preparing the shipment of cocoons. Fergana, near the Chinese border, is the Soviet Union's largest silk-producing region. Davan, once famed for its sky horses, is now known for its silk. When the Chinese army came here 2 centuries before Christ in search of the sky horses, it is recorded that they launched an attack on a fortress called Eshi. Eshi is believed to have been at the eastern end of the Fergana Basin, where the town of Osh now stands. It is here that we come upon a most unexpected discovery. This picture, shown to us by Professor Makrinin of the Kyrgyz Science Academy, is a tracing of a sky horse drawing discovered just 4 years ago. The people of Fergana went into the mountains where they found wild horses. These were the sky horses. The long, slender neck and legs are what makes the horses of Fergana unique. This is exactly the same type of horse. The difference between these two drawings is that these sacrificial animals here are two deer. And this is one of the men of Fergana. The drawing of the sky horse was found near the peak of a rock mountain called Suyotash, about 200 kilometers from Osh. Drawings of sky horses have so far been found at three places in the Fergana Basin. These at Suyotash are the best and the best preserved. There we can see the drawing of the deer which we saw earlier. The one at the bottom looks as though it is the oldest, and the top one is the clearest. According to Professor MacLennan, these pictures were drawn in the 5th century BC. The small head, the extended neck, and the long, slender legs, these were said to be the mark of the sky horses. The deer was an offering to the sky horses. The style of these pictures suggests that the sky horses were not mere animals, but also protective gods that had the power to drive away enemies and maintain peace and happiness. From their vantage point over the Fergana Basin, these sky horses were probably thought to pray for prosperity. We came upon a herd of some 30 horses, kicking up a cloud of dust on the plain. We learned they are racing horses from a nearby stable. As renowned as Fergana once was for its horses, herds this large are a rare sight today. No one knows exactly what became of the famed sky horses. At some point over the last 2,000 years, apparently they simply disappeared from the plains of Middle Asia. While most people in the Fergana Basin are today Muslim, long ago, it was Buddhism that held sway here. There now remains, however, only one relic of Buddhism. This is Dr. Takayasu Higuchi, honorary professor of the University of Kyoto. This is the ruin of Kuva in the fields on the outskirts of a town. Here lie the remains of a Buddhist temple built between the 7th and 8th centuries. These ruins provide important evidence of the passage of Buddhism through Middle Asia and on to China. The ruins cover a large area. From this point, we were able to see how big Fagana really is. The remains of the Buddhist temple were over to our right. Dr. Higuchi explained that what was particularly interesting is the relation between the position of the town and that of the temple. It helps us to understand the relation between the city and the temple, which was originally located outside the protective walls of the old town. Two adjoining buildings have now been excavated.
これが、これも壁ですね。2つ、これ壁ですね。これとこれが2つ建物が2つある。これ壁ですね。これでこっちが北の建物な。そうですね。これでこっちが北の建物で、北の建物は東から北がこうずっともう壊されてるよね。そして、こっちが、しかしいずれも長方形で、
This is the northern building. We can see the ruins all the way from the east to the north. And on this side, it looks as if there was a square with six pillars. That was the entrance, and there were three pillars on each side here. This looks like the southern entrance. In the center of the square was an open space, and in the exact center of that was a square platform. These temples usually had a stupa, a cylindrical tower, all the way round here. Along the east wall, we can see a long bench-like structure. This small alcove was probably for some kind of light, rather than for a statue of Buddha. This is the bench. At places like Ajina Tepe, a recumbent Buddha was placed here. This Bodhisattva statue was unearthed at the Kuva ruins. Most unusual are the three eyes. According to Professor Higuchi, this may reflect the influence of Hinduism. Besides the Bodhisattva, several strange statues were also found. Sri Deva, the goddess with a corona of three skulls. She represents beauty and unlimited wisdom. Searching carefully in the dirt, Professor Higuchi finds a small colored fragment. He says it is from the original 7th century wall. It is a tiny piece of blue clay, barely a centimeter long, but it conjures up a vision of how magnificent this temple must once have been. the tranquil, innocent face of the Buddha. This statue is typical of the Buddhas of Middle Asia. The Termez region, south of Fergana, in the Uzbek Soviet Socialist Republic, is a treasure house of Buddhist ruins. Only a few kilometers away lies Afghanistan. The triad of Buddha and his two monks was discovered here at the Fayaz Tepe Temple. The walls and roof here were built of sun-dried bricks. This area was where the monks lived and trained. Buddhism came to Termez from its birthplace in India through Afghanistan during the Kushan dynasty in the 1st century BC. Buddhism here reached its peak in those early years. This is Termez today. Across the river is Afghanistan. Entry by foreigners is extremely tightly controlled. Even Soviet citizens need special permission to come here. Our camera team's activities were strictly limited. But we were allowed to film the Buddhist ruins and part of the town. The Buddhist ruins at Zumala. All that remains now is this stupa in an overgrown field, battered by the elements. Kirkiz, the summer palace of the king who ruled this region. Even after the decline of Buddhism here, Termez remained an important stop on the Silk Road. The 9th century palace speaks to the prosperity of the region. This two-story palace had over 50 rooms, overflowing with the rare products of distant lands. It was said that the bustle of life within the palace could be heard from the far side of the river. Strange indeed have been the twists of fate for the rulers and the peoples of Middle Asia. Even Buddhism itself was not destined to last long here. Most recently, the Termez region has been caught up in the tension of the fighting in Afghanistan. One thing alone remained constant throughout the centuries, the ceaseless passage of man along the Silk Road.